We live in a world full of different sounds. We like listening to rustling leaves, the rain, birds singing, but we don't realise how easy it is to lose that. We are surrounded by sounds and noises of a modern world from which we want to hide. And headphones are here to help us and have become a fashion trend in our lives. But our ears do not like this. Do headphones damage our ears? Let's figure it out. Before we get started, let's find out the history of headphones. Rewind to a century ago. In 1910, an American Nathaniel Baldwin invented the first model of headphones in his kitchen for the US Navy. These headphones were used for radio communication only. Later, in 1952, another American, John Koss, the founder of Koss Corporation, invented the first stereo headphones for personal use. As a result, headphones became widely used in everyday life. 27 years later, an engineer at Sony, Nobutoshi Kohara, created a cassette player Walkman and on-ear headphones for his general director, Akio Morita, so that he could listen to operas during air travel. A little bit later, Sony invented the first earbuds for greater comfort and mobility. As a cassette only fits a small number of songs, the company Apple released the iPod, which can hold around 1,000 songs. So, because of the pocket player, the white earbuds became famous. In 2008, a hip-hop singer and producer, Dr. Dre, releases his own headphones label, Monster Beats. These over-ear headphones also led the market in popularity and the fashion of headphones today. Not only music lovers wear headphones, they are also preferable to people who work with music professionally. Like our character, Vyacheslav, pseudonym Slava Petrov. He makes crowds happy through his profession in music. He is a DJ. I both write and pick over music. On average, I spend 9 hours a day wearing headphones. His concerts last from between 3 to 6 hours. With a lifestyle like this, certainly hearing loss will come. At the moment, I have a hearing problem with my right ear. Not much, but when I am listening to music, it feels muffled. Besides Slava, many people with different kinds of professions also live in a world of music. Obviously, an era of hearing loss is coming. But what exactly is hearing loss? A medical dictionary says that hearing loss is any degree of impairment of the ability to apprehend sound. There are three types of hearing loss, but we are only interested in one, sensorineural. Sensorineural hearing loss is a disease that can be congenital or acquired. It is caused by loud noises and could affect workmen at loud construction sites or even from just listening to music too loudly. To be clearer, let's see how the human ear perceives sound. Sound waves enter the outer ear canal, hit the eardrum, and travel along the ossicular chain to the inner ear. Then sound is transmitted along the auditory nerve to the brain by the cochlea. The louder the sound, the higher the number of decibels. Here are some examples. 20 decibels, a clock ticking. It is the lowest level for ears. 30 decibels, whispering. A normal conversation reaches 50 decibels. If you scream out, the noise level reaches 75 decibels. Moscow Metro is considered the loudest in the world. Precisely, it is 100 decibels. Here is the threshold for pain. The noise of a jackhammer can reach 130 decibels. The limit for the ear is 140 decibels. Fireworks and firecrackers can reach that level of noise. So, besides being a DJ, the most dangerous noise occupations are train drivers, factory workers, and builders. Is it possible to get hearing back with conditions like these? Hearing restoration is possible in early stages, where hearing gets down to 30, 40 or 50 decibels. These are mild and moderate degrees of hearing loss. But returning hearing to its original condition after severe damage is virtually impossible. Loud music not only damages your hearing, but also the whole human body. A heightened level of noise can cause symptoms such as headaches, sleep disturbances, tiredness, and memory loss. Hearing loss occurs gradually and imperceptibly. People who have been able to see and hear in the past that are suffering from hearing loss struggle to adapt. The person cannot perceive obtained information, and they will become irritable. Life changes because of their condition, and they start to look at life differently. Let's find out what kind of headphones are less dangerous for our health. In-ear headphones are very close to the inner ear, thus they contribute to the death of inner ear hair cells. Therefore, earbuds can cause progressive hearing loss in the future. These kinds of headphones are the most dangerous. The next type is called on-ear headphones. These headphones are worn on the ears, but don't entirely cover them. That's why they are safer to use than earbuds. But because they just cover the ears, you must increase the volume of the player to muffle background noises. It is bad for your ears when you do this. And finally, over-the-ear headphones, also called full-size headphones. These completely surround the ear, creating a vacuum that doesn't let background noise reach your ear. This type of headphone is the safest for listening to music. Slava is going to check the condition of his ears. So, your outer ear canal is clean. You also have no inflammation of the eardrum. Nevertheless, the problem that brought you here will remain. To understand how much your hearing is lost, we must conduct an audiometric hearing test. This test is also called an audiogram. It shows the frequency at which Slava's hearing gets worse. Using special headphones, the patient receives sounds at different frequencies and volumes. Each time the patient hears a beep, he presses the button. As you said, your right ear hears worse, although your left ear also hears badly. The problem is that you experience loud sounds for long periods of time, and that destroys your hearing and hair cells of the inner ear. Your hearing loss is still in the early stages. You have much to consider, because if you continue to listen to loud music, your hearing will inevitably decline and you will feel worse. What about you? How long since you visited an ENT specialist? Let's do an experiment. If you hit a group of auditory risk. To start, turn on the radio via the speakers. Choose a talk station and set a quiet volume where you can make out the words. Then start listening to music in headphones at a normal volume for you. In an hour, take your headphones off and turn on the radio without a volume changing. If you hear nothing, there is a temporary threshold shift. If noise exposure lasts during the whole night, such as at disco, it will probably take more than 6 to 8 hours for the auditory nerve to fully recover. It is more likely to take a day or maybe even longer. And if noise exposure is repeated regularly, the auditory nerve is no longer able to restore its function, and then hearing loss begins. So what to do if I want to listen to music, but don't want to be deaf? Here are several solutions. Wear earplugs either for street or transport noise. Try to listen to music with headphones for no longer than 60 minutes a day at 60% of the maximum volume. Besides these tips, I have another quite interesting one. Have you heard about the Mozart effect? This effect normalizes the organs in your body when you listen to music composed by Mozart. By the way, does Slava decide to protect his hearing?
Yeah, this way is also possible.